Well, this looks gargantuan. No, not really, actually. These zones look really big, so whenever I see a big chamber like this in another game, I'd be like, oh my goodness, we're gonna be puzzle solving in here for like 5 hours. But in this game, it mostly means, oh, I can turn left or right. Sometimes I just go straight, and that's the only option. Hey! Thought I'd find a secret over here. Ah, we missed one again. I'm kind of resigned to my fate there. Oh wait, yeah, the one I missed is the one that... Isn't it the one we saw, but I couldn't figure out how to get? I think is what was happening. Oh, weird. He wouldn't let me go down. I have a decent percentage of them so far, I think. No new costumes yet, though. Just this one that I've been running around with since, like, the beginning now. Wonder if I've missed some of those. Why are you acting afraid of a door? I guess he just gasps in response to everything right now. So he can go that way, but I can't follow, so we have to find a different route. And that's not a pun about all the roots that are around me right now. Roots and roots of both types and both spellings. Is this a dead end? I think it is. Yep. Alright, buddy. Thanks for waiting for me. Very polite. Who made those stairs? Seriously. Maybe the whole thing must have settled or fell down a little bit. It really doesn't seem like it, though. It really seems like the stairs just didn't make sense ever. It's like they started making one side and then the other side, and they were carving it from stone by hand. And it's all from a giant block. And before long, they realized, oh, the two sides of these stairs aren't going to match up. Well, there's no way of fixing that, ever. Unfortunately, you can't climb up these slopes that seem completely climbable. So you have to do platforming instead. Alright, down we go. Nope. That was not valid, apparently. Oh. Now I'm trapped down here, so I gotta go around. Oh no! All these one-way paths. Who makes a town like this? Why would you do that? Just why? Was that not poop covered? Yeah, I guess you can't climb that. But I can go over there and climb that, I guess? Is brown grass gonna be the new poop cliffs? Because the ledges are all... Because the whole buildings are white now, so they can't have poop on the ledge because I can't... If they're going by poop, they wouldn't be able to see that, so now they have to have brown grass perfectly growing in straight lines to replace the poopy ledges. Huh. Video games are weird, man. Yep, yeah, that confirms it. Brown grass is the new poopy ledge. Let's go, buddy. Just marching towards what feels like your inevitable death. Ooh, there's a whole spot down there. But I can't get back up, can I? Whoa, don't fall off. Yeah, it's the same, like, under bridge we saw before. Or I'm not sure what its purpose is. Can I grab the backs of these ledges? No. That's all water down there? I could probably jump down there, but would I want to? Oh, they gave me poopy ledges. I can climb back up. Okay, then let's go down there and see what the secret inevitably is that they're hiding down here. Or not. Is there nowhere else to climb? How did you do that? He rolled in the water. That over there we've been to before, right? Isn't that where I just was? Yeah, so there's no reason to go there. Huh. And there's no, like, keyhole or something around here? Weird. This does almost support that idea I had before, where I thought that maybe they made a bunch of spots to hide collectibles, and then ran out of collectibles to place there, so they're like, just leave it. Or maybe that was all an elaborate thing to catch you if you fell, I guess, so you could get it way back up. Definitely feels like that somewhere where a collectible would go. Yeah, let's not visit the relatives over there. Hey there. So you called me an elevator. Can I climb that, by the way? Nope. Not that way. Right, that's the thing he went down. He went down that track when he was just ahead. Which means I've been all over the place in here. So I think we're just ready to go. I'll take it. Yay, we didn't get separated. I kind of thought we would. And now you can destroy those briars. There we go. Now I'm somewhere I think we've been here before. Hey, the dog. We haven't seen him for a while. I think everything else is all locked up and we can't do anything with it. Did I ever go down here? Oh yeah, I remember trying to check here. That was actually a decent while ago. There's almost like a Metroidvania thing going on with the level design here, except for the part where it's completely linear progression and I don't really need to explore in order to figure out where to go. But the linear path we're taking and are totally locked onto is kind of looping onto itself in an interesting way, reinforcing the narrative feel of the idea that you needed this character to come back with you in order to make it possible to do stuff. Oh, this is the place where I missed the collectible. Can you destroy them? Are they gonna come back? That's what I needed. So I didn't miss it, basically. Because the reason why I didn't have it wasn't because I couldn't figure it out, but because that dude needed to come here and make it possible. Hey! We've only missed one now. Alright. I was regretting that. I'm like, oh, did I screw up? Now I know. Oh boy. And this makes so that was like a reward for you figuring out how to deal with this guy sooner. But you're gonna have to figure it out either way in order to proceed here, because there's a whole crowd there and it's impossible to continue without doing what I just did. But as a reward for intuiting that quicker, you get that collectible upstairs. Neat. It does make me wonder though. Hang on a second. Just put this down. There's also this upstairs area that seemed to not do anything, but there was always, like, guys blocking it. Did that guy create such a big shockwave that they're gone now? And if so, is there anything hidden behind them? Yeah, they're gone too. That goes nowhere. That goes nowhere. And this just drops down to where I just was. So, no is the answer. Aw. Now that would have been a sneaky place to hide a costume, because then you like, you go through on your way back and you find out how to finally solve that puzzle, and then like right behind the solution for the puzzle is also a secondary spot that they think that they would expect you to forget about, that happens to have the collectible inside of it. I just don't want to miss out on things. Oh boy, bad times. Boy, you really have some firepower. What is this here for? I wonder. Can't really see my surroundings very well. Oh, now I might be stuck. Get out of here. Go on, get. I'll just grab another one for security's sake. They just get destroyed. It's like we're just straight up nuking them at some point. But are we still en route to get to the all the way back to the spot where that one was too like dead to help me? Oh yeah, this should be right over there. Columnar jointing. I've got to at least try, right? Yep, you die. Worth a check. Wouldn't want to miss anything that they hid down there. And water's usually safe to fall in. But they have to kill you, because I don't think there's a way back up. Grace ya. Oh no, he's sad. He's sad, so he's storming off without solving the puzzle. Although he didn't seem perturbed by the other ones we passed by on the way here. Oh, is he going downstairs to discover the room where there's like tons of them? The columnar jointing room, full of columnar jointing. Have I mentioned the columnar jointing? It's in freaking every game now. Every game. It's just like, it's become generic fantasy landscape, is columnar jointing. Oh, there goes that wall. And that just materialized? Oh, because he stepped on that thing. We're not going to go open that door with your silhouette? Alright. So something needs to be put here, and maybe even over there. Let's poke around then. Where are we right now? There's an orb down there. Well, that's a dead end. Ah, it would connect to that if there was currently a platform there, but there's not. Was that my fox friend? So if I go up there, I can get across, but how do I get up? Oh, there we go. Oh, but you need to be over there. Okay, so... Can you come over here? Alright. Hey, buddy. Buddy. I just need you to stand on this for a second. There we go. Stay put for just a minute, and that'll give me stairs. Please don't leave the stairs yet. There we go. And then I think I can drop this down on the other side. No, I can't. Now without being there. Oh, does he know? He knows how to get there on his own, though. Okay. I guess I can just put this down. Oh, is this useless without the something else put in place? I actually don't see what I'm trying to... I guess just put something... Probably just put an orb on that thing and then line it up. That's probably what we're going for. But for now, this is useless. I think. Oh yeah, I can even climb all the way up there. There's a bunch of things to climb on. What can I do in here? I can climb. Not quite. Video games sure love their linear climbing segments now. Uncharted, what have you done to us? Yep. There we go. Just follow the yellow brick road, except that the yellow brick road is bird shit, probably. Here we go. Alright. Listen, so I'm practicing my God-given right. So is the wall gonna go away? Yep. Now I can press two things at once. Not entirely sure why I need to, but I'll just put it over here. That makes you move over there. But I probably want to put an orb on the end, right? Please don't chase me when I have this thing, because if you come after me, then I won't be able to control you. That's it, right? Hopefully. Right. And this is decently designed, because now I can't use an orb, so I can't call him over to that. But I have a cube now, so it doesn't matter. I don't need to call him around anymore. So now if I go up top, I can just look through the thing, get the perspective puzzle done, and go get that door open, or whatever is going to happen when I do that. So I will now proceed to ignore that puzzle for a bit. So I want to look around a little bit. That's not for me. That's when he climbs. These are all dead. Maybe they'll all get revived. Oh, will I have like an army of friends? Yeah, both these side doors I can't use. They're just for them. Oh. I think we're staging a mass revive with that thing. We've done perspective before. I'm gonna line it up with that ball, that circle on the wall, which is way bigger, which means that the perspective trick's gonna somehow make it way bigger, and then it's gonna be one of those giant orbs that I use to give this guy life, and there will be tons of them instead. There we go. Going exactly as I thought.
Ha!
Some of them definitely look healthier and safe and happier than other ones. Some of them are really droopy and wobbly, while some of them are walking really straight. I appreciate that they didn't just give them all the same animation, but then made them all different from each other. The one in the front is mine, right? I think. So it's one of the ones that kind of sucks at walking by comparison. Hello. Aha, I beat you. Oh no, that one's mine. Almost certainly. Hey, there we go. Now there's five more of them. Now what do I do? I forget, is there a perspective thing to activate in here, or do I just yell at this thing and go for it? Oh, or do I just stand here? There we go. Go, 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 go! I get my own victory parade. I bet that means we're leaving this region soon now. Or, like, right now. Oh yeah, they both have exit routes. Oh, he's leaving me. Bye. Ah, okay, hi. Now there's even more of them. Whoa. Infinite loop. All right, I guess I've revived this city then as a whole. Or something like that. Here we are. Another world complete. Fox, we had the bird storm, and now we've done the automaton level. I'm calling them these things because this is one of those mini games that doesn't have words in it ever, so I'm just like, I don't know, I'll make up my own things to call stuff. Creative license. So based on that, I would assume that it's time for world 4? Oh, hey! One of these guys is here. Oh, they're all coming through here. Huh. I have to swim. Whatever it is seems to be underwater. I wonder if I can walk on top of these guys, like platforms or something. It'll be interesting to see how this manifests.
Well, now.
Now we've got the origin for the cape. This stranger or silhouette or family member or whoever that can't seem to find, and whenever we see them, they seem to teleport away, which seems to suggest that they're not alive or not real, or we're like imagining them, or they're just really rude and trolling us or something. Apparently went overboard, and our cape, which looks all shaggy, shoddy and everything, is actually theirs. Well, he's not happy to be here. Hey, I was right about them carrying me across the water. Neat. So these are just gonna be a mechanic now, I guess? They're gonna stick around? Oh. I guess it seems like he might be the same one that was with us before, so maybe he will stick around too. So whoever we lost on the boat seems to have mattered to us, because we made a point to keep their cape around, and why would you bother, generally? Unless you cared about the person. There we go, I figured this was a side area. I saw the glowy spot. So I still managed to miss one in the last world, apparently. Somewhere in that last section, huh? I guess this level must be short, or just they couldn't find places for secrets, because there's two of them total, and that was one of them already. Huh. Now the poopy ledges are just water that's brighter, I guess? Alright. The Poopy Ledge legacy continues. Our character seems terrified and cold at the all the time now. Even the sound that I make to light up the thing is just him panting and crying, basically, at this point. It seems like there's some kind of three-ring weapon thing. Oh, never mind. I thought it was shooting at a beam that repels the ghosts, but not, or the phantoms, or whatever we want to call them, the shades. But actually, it looks like it's just pointing out that the fox is supposed to guide the kid past the shades and into this ruin. And I guess that ruin must somehow protect everyone. Or must solve my problems, or at least just some kind of prophecy foretold type thing. Definitely doing the journey thing where like some sort of tapestry or mural is kind of vaguely hinting at what my destiny is, and it's unclear as to whether or not I even understand what that is, or knew in advance, or anything like that. I can't tell if it's conveying it to the player, and just the player, or the player and me. I can't tell if it's supposed to convey it to the player, or the player and the character at the same time. There's no way I'm jumping that high. Nope. They made it possible for me to jump up here, so I thought they might be stashing something.